Biot-savart's law gives us the magnetic field due to current carrying conductor, and that conductor should be a small conductor. Now, with help of that law and doing the necessary derivation, we can find out the magnetic field due to different shapes. Different shapes means the current is flowing in a straight long conductor, the current is flowing in a circle, the current is flowing in a solenoid, and there may be different type of shapes. So we will apply Biot-savart's law, and that is the application of Biot-savart's law to find out magnetic field with different shapes of current. Now, the first shape we take is magnetic field due to current carrying circular coil. Okay, so current carrying circular coil, I take it here. Now, in this current is flowing, let us say, anti-clockwise. We have to learn it two ways. Number one, what will be the distribution of magnetic field at different points? And number two, what is the magnetic field at its center? So first we will see magnetic field at the center. Okay. At center. Current I is flowing in a circular loop, and this has got a radius equal to R. Take this small element of current. This is DL, current flowing I. So IDL is the current element, and this current element will produce a magnetic field at distance R, at the center O. Now, the angle between DL and R is 90 degree, circumference and radius 90 degree, and we can find out using Biot-savart's law. Magnetic field at the center dB is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I DL sine 90 upon square of the distance, R square sine 90 is equal to 1. This is the small magnetic field here created due to this small current element. Now I take another current element, find out the magnetic field, another current element, find out the magnetic field, another current element, find out the magnetic field, and join all the magnetic fields. Okay. If there is a superposition, then it has to be a vector addition. Now, what is the direction of this magnetic field dB created by this, and I apply right hand rule. This is the direction of current, this is R, this is the palm, and I bend it this way. So the magnetic field comes out here. The magnetic field will be outward. Now, because of this current, the current is going up. I set it this way. The current is going up, but this is on this side, so I turn it this way. Current is going up, this is the palm, and bend it this way. This also comes out. So for this also, dB is outward. Now, if I take this one, then this is the current. O is here, upper side. So I put this current and this up this way. Bend it outside. So dB is outward. For this, again, for this I put it this way, and O is here, and bend it this way, this comes outside. So outward is the magnetic field. Because of each and every element, dB will be outward. Therefore, if it is all in the same direction, we simply have to add them. Okay, now adding all the dBs, that is known as integration. So this integration, both sides, integration of dB is equal to integration of mu naught upon 4 pi I dl upon r square. Now this integration is to be done for all the dl's, complete dl's. That will give the complete dv, and complete dv will be known as b. So b is equal to, this is a constant, current everywhere is same, so this is constant. R for each dl is same, it is not changing, that is also a constant. Now integration is only for dl. So here dl, 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 dl for the complete circuit closed. For the complete circle, the closed integration of dl is, you all know it is 2 pi r, okay, the total circumference length, this. So this gives us b is equal to mu naught pi pi is cancelled, mu naught I upon 2 r, that's all. 1 r is cancelled, pi is cancelled, 2 is cancelled, mu naught pi 2 r. This is magnetic field where at center. So this is magnetic field at the center. Okay, remember this, and now we will see the magnetic field at different locations. That is, what is magnetic field here, 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 how it changes. Okay, I will tell you the shape in the next lecture. Thank you.